Parabola 1. So, construct the parabola using the locus method. So, in this, we start with the directrix, which is a straight line at the front of the arrow in this circumstance. Now, with the directrix drawn, we draw a line perpendicular to it. The focal point is 50 millimeters from the directrix. So, we measure out 50 millimeters. Like so. Yeah. If we bisect this line of 50 millimeters, project the line down through, where the line cuts the other one, gives us a point on our parabola. From our drawing, we know that the parabola projects back another 60 millimeters beyond the focal point. Divide this up into spacings. For this, it was divided up into 20 mm spacing. Project straight lines down through each one of these. Then, with the compass, measure from the directrix to each one of these division lines and swing this from the focal point onto the relevant division line, as shown. So again, from the directrix to the division line, from the focal point, ensure it's the focal point, and swing it on to the relevant lines again. Once more, ensure to measure from the directrix to the division line. Place the point of the compass on the focal point and then swing an arc onto the relevant division line. Then from this, we have all our points located, so we can freehand sketch in a parabola. Some lines may not have been projected far enough, so continue the model. This done, we can ink in the drawing. Then continue the drawing to produce the bow and arrow as described in the question. You can see the strings come back a further 50 millimeters beyond the parabola, like so. Connect this point back to the two points of the parabola. Now we will draw the arrow. So 20 millimeters from the string and mark two 10 millimeter divisions. You can see it rises 10 millimeters above and below. So project this line straight across so we can use this for the front of the arrow also. In the question, it shows that the slope goes up 10 millimeters and over 10. Connect up the two corners. This is also a 45 degree line. I'm going to do the front of the arrow, and it's parallel, so that is also 45 degrees, projected out to the line that we've brought over to the front. You can now ink in the drawing to complete it. And finally, mark in the directrix.